If you are ingesting a large amount of data for analysis or looking to simplify the development of event-driven microservices, then you need to check out Cloud PubSub. PubSub Made Easy is a series dedicated to helping you understand Cloud PubSub inside out. So let's get started by going through an overview today. Adam and I are collaborating on a project, but we are based in different parts of the world. I'm here in California and he's in Australia. So I just do my part on the Google Doc and assign it to him for review. And he does the same. This allows us to receive messages and act on them in our own working hours. Essentially asynchronously, we don't have to be available at the same time and are still able to get the project done. Cloud PubSub is based on the same concept but for applications and services. PubSub helps build robust, scalable systems of applications by integrating them asynchronously. CatOut is a website to purchase fun cat posters. When a user orders a pretty poster, CatOut packages the order, ships it to the user, and notifies them. In a very simplistic service-oriented architecture, they would need at least four microservices: a packaging service to pack the poster, a shipping service, to generate labels, and a notification service to send notification to the user about the status of their order. All these tied to an order manager service, granted that there'll be some payment services or reporting service, etc., but for the purpose of this conversation, let's assume those all exist. Now, let's trace what happens when a user orders a piece of art. The order service receives the order and sends a message to the packaging service. The packaging service then does the necessary processing to package the poster and sends a message to the shipping service to ship it. The shipping service does the necessary processing to ship the package and sends a message to the notification service, which notifies the customer that an order is processed. In the same way, the order and packaging service also send messages to the notification service to send to the customer the updated information on their order. There are some problems with this arrangement, though. One, it's just complicated with a lot of arrows. But as we drill deeper, what happens if a service, say the packaging service, fails? Well, we need some kind of retry mechanism that will keep the whole system from breaking. Can be done, but a lot of work. What happens if a new service gets introduced, like a monitoring service that logs all of these transactions to a central store? This service needs to interface with all the other services, which will also require making a change in all the other services. That makes the developers work really hard. Think about testing. That'll be hard too. We will need mock services to test each of the individual service. Let's say I need to test my packaging service. Because it is dependent on the shipping, order, and notification service, I need to mock up all of those services just to test my packaging service, which is a lot of work. What if you want to scale this system? If there are three instances of packaging service, there would be a load balancer involved. You would not know how to cancel the order, which stage it is in, and can it still be canceled? This is where Cloud PubSub comes to rescue. Cloud PubSub is a fully managed, real-time messaging service that allows you to send and receive messages between independent applications. Once an event is successfully published as a message, it becomes the job of this service to ensure that all the systems that need to react to this event get it. The idea behind asynchronous integrations is to react to events represented as messages. In our example, messages merely represent events happening in the real world, like order received, package shipped, etc. Let's see CatOut's flow of events with Cloud PubSub now. The order service, instead of sending messages directly to the packaging service, will just send these messages to PubSub where they'll be stored. The packaging service and the notification service will receive these messages either by a push or a pull. Packaging service, instead of directly sending messages to shipping service, would send them to PubSub, and the event will be received by the shipping and notification service. The packaging service did not need to know which services are receiving this event. This makes it simple. Similarly, the shipping service sends the messages to PubSub from where the order and the notification service pull or receive those messages. By using Cloud PubSub, we've solved a lot of problems that we had in the earlier architecture. Well, one, we've made each piece simpler, since it only needs to emit an event without worrying about who gets it, or receive an event without much care about how it got there. But more importantly, this is more scalable. It reduces dependencies. Services can change and don't need to know about each other's changes. All that need to be made sure is that they are subscribing to PubSub and receiving the right messages. It's also much easier now to introduce new services. If our new monitoring service pops up, all we need to do is make sure it subscribes to the messages from the existing service via Cloud PubSub. The architecture with Cloud PubSub has built-in resilience. If any service were to break down, PubSub will store the messages for 7 days or until the service comes back up and is delivered then. And because PubSub is fully managed service, you don't have to worry about it being single point of failure. It's scalable and resilient and can handle millions of messages simultaneously. All right, so today we learned when to use Cloud PubSub and the common challenges it solves. Join us next time to learn how it works and some of the most common use cases. If you like this video and would like to see more such content, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel.